So what's going on, guys? Thank you so much for tuning into the Skater Informant. So a year after I posted this video, Nigel Houston arrested, a year later, this happened on June 30th, 2019, it's been actually a year plus, this individual decides to make another appearance on the Skater Informant channel. Now, this time a little bit different because it's completely voluntary. But before I tell you what's happening today, what just happened recently to me, to my channel, from this guy, let's just take a ride down memory lane and remember what happened a year ago. Okay, so literally, guys, that was it. Him tapping on the hood of the car and David Loy gets bumping into the, a bumper a bit, was the actual incident that happened. Now things escalated into this.
Car!
You drove out and
you would have ran into us. You would have ran into us.
You're not supposed to be going down there.
It's a sidewalk.
What do you mean?
It's a sidewalk.
Stop filming me, dude.
You're a fucking idiot.
You're a fucking...
You don't protect my car, you faggot.
Car!
You drove out and
you would have ran into us.
Now, 2 days ago, I get the following email in my inbox. Dear Skater Informant, this is to inform you that we have received a privacy complaint from an individual regarding your content. A privacy complaint. And they try to pinpoint the occurrence in my video, and it says it starts from 0 minutes and zero... 0 seconds to 7 minutes and 12 seconds, which means the entirety of the video. There is a violation in the entirety of my Nigel goes to jail caused by that Josh Nazar dude. And in the little paragraph underneath the complaint, it says how, you know, YouTube has some tools they provided, some blurring tools that can help me, you know, make sure the video meets their standards and doesn't violate any kind of privacy, etc. But how do you freaking blur a violation that occurs from the beginning of the video to the end of the video? That's stupid. That obviously sounds like this is a auto-generated template that not a human being actually typed, and one that's just used universally for like all complaints. So this is just baloney. This is not legit, or it's not accurate, at least what it's saying. It says, you know, there's importance about respecting people's privacy and I shouldn't violate it. And if I had more questions, I should look at their privacy guidelines. Now, in all fairness, YouTube actually does mention at some point that people's first name, like their legal names, are or could be considered a privacy breach or violation if it's shared. But what YouTube doesn't seem to understand is that this person that we're talking about is a person that actually works in the entertainment industry. What does that mean? Does that change anything? Yes, it does, because this person's sole job and objective in life is to become well known or better known. He's to attract people's attention as a failing comedian. He is trying to generate, you know, audiences and a following and get his name out there. So it's just, it's such an easy debate to, you know, prove your point. So I just respond respectfully, say, hey, you know, thank you for sending me this. I'm just very confused because in this video you're basically saying that the violation is the entirety of the video, which, you know, makes no sense to me. And I make sure I bold these words and I say that I have not shared any private information. There's no addresses, no license plates, no phone numbers, or any other sensitive information. Basically anything that can help people pinpoint this person's location, you know, that's not being disclosed anywhere. And I also highlight literally that this person is a person in the media. So he thrives, he benefits. He already on his own gets his name out there. So there is no breach. The only thing that can be happening, I can be helping his career from a advertising perspective. You know what they say, there's no such thing as bad advertising. You're just getting exposure or getting your name shared out there. So that's just silly to say that I'm breaching his privacy when You basically don't have any if you're an entertainer. I also highlight how this video was filmed in a public location. This was not some kind of hidden camera. He literally acknowledges he was being recorded. What I actually do make a point here is I suspect YouTube that this person is simply trying to hide the fact that he used extremely offensive language to an individual that he basically ran over. But you know, that's besides the point. So he's trying to suppress the information, trying to keep it hidden, and trying to make sure the least amount of people see it. So he's actually abusing the tool, you know, and using it illegally because he's basically obstructing my income generation just because he doesn't want people to know. No, I messed up. Dang it, I should have said that. Well, I can try to find all the videos that have mentioned this and get them, you know, blocked or demonetized or removed or whatever. So that's what he's doing. This happened a year ago. So by him doing this, he's actually reviving the conversation. He's bringing it back up. He's making it a thing again, which is basically counterintuitive, kind of productive to whatever he was trying to achieve. So of course we're talking about it now. In all honesty, that video just got like a little over 2,000 views. The original one where the incident happened before he was identified got 18,000 views. But the likelihood that this may get blocked and suppressed is pretty high, to be honest. You know, my channel is relatively small. So if, you know, somebody's watching here, you have a YouTube channel, you have an Instagram, I would really appreciate you sharing this, retweet it, repost it, forward it, whatever you gotta do. But I don't want this information to go away just because he wanted it to. That's not how this works. People are not allowed to bury their wrongdoings without formally apologizing, without acknowledging it, taking fault and responsibility, accountability, all of those. You can't just get away with stuff. Nigel went to jail. That did happen. How can you undo that? So yeah, I don't know what's gonna happen, but I would definitely appreciate your assistance if we just get this reshared. And I don't, if you have a YouTube channel, you wanna repost this, by all means do it. I will not claim a you know, copyright infringement, none of that silly stuff. I just want the knowledge to be out there. I don't care if I don't get monetized for your stuff. If you're reposting mine, just share the knowledge. That's what a social media slash, you know, a video platform is about, to getting information out there. So guys, that is it for now. Tonight, the 48 hours that YouTube gave me expires. So tomorrow or just after today, we'll know for sure what's gonna happen. If my video gets demonetized, if it gets blocked, removed, we'll know. And I guess I'll update you guys then, whatever happens. Or maybe they'll understand and they won't take it off and they won't demonetize it, I don't know. But yeah, I'll share the news with you. Guys, thank you so much for watching. I am the Skate Informant. You've been informed. My job here is done. And I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.